currently 8 faculty that are part of the Orthopedic Trauma Fellowship and 2 fellows. And so we get to spend a considerable amount of time with our fellows and get to know them, and they get to know us. Having so many faculty around is beneficial for fellows because they get to kind of assimilate many years of clinical experience. So we talk about the practice of medicine, and we don't always agree on how something should be handled. And so you get to see from fellow's perspective is that there are more or is more than one way to tackle a problem, probably successfully. So you get to watch us banter back and forth about how we should do something or what's the best way, and you get to kind of incorporate all of that into your practice going forward. I think one of the key parts of our program is our meeting at 6:30. And so at that meeting, it's a group meeting with faculty, fellows, residents, our advanced practice provider staff, our research coordinators, and we go over all of the cases that came in the previous day. We go over all the surgeries that were done the previous day. We go over non-operative consults, and we spend some legitimate time talking about those cases, from what we will be doing that day in the OR for the cases that need surgery, and then debriefing the cases that we did the day before, struggles and just what the experience was like, what things can be done better, and tips and tricks. And that happens near 365 days a year. And so that's an hour long every single day that is, in my opinion, unparalleled fellow education. So after that, the day typically turns into a work day where you either go to clinic. So we rotate the fellows through clinic with each of the faculty, and they spend one day a week in clinic with whoever's faculty service they're on. If you're not in clinic, then you're pretty much in the OR. So you're in the OR 4 days a week, and then you're doing whichever cases came in or that you're choosing to do that day. In a given week, we do have some special dedicated time to education. And so on Tuesday mornings, we rotate throughout the month between an indications and a research conference. And then multidisciplinary conference, which we coordinate with the general surgery, anesthesia, emergency room services. Wednesday mornings are our dedicated orthopedic trauma grand rounds, where we have a curriculum that we go through each year that basically covers the depth and breadth of orthopedic trauma, from fracture care to post-traumatic problems such as infections and non-unions, to aspects of arthroplasty, pain management, and the list just goes on. And on Friday each week, we engage with the orthopedic residency program here and do aspects of residency fracture conference, where sometimes we're just passive observers, sometimes we're table instructors for their skill sessions, and sometimes we're actually leading the sessions. And so that's 3 dedicated hours a week for education. Fellows are always interested in what's going to be the level of independence, and starting to basically come into their own and do surgeries with some oversight around so that there can be help, but really see if they can do it. I think that's an important question. And so we foster here what I'd call a pathway to independence for the fellows. And so there's an intentional progression of responsibility there. We do a lot of surgery, and we're going to do a lot of the same surgeries over and over. And so we're able to watch the fellows, first of all, show them how we do it, and then do it with them several times, and then ultimately get to a point where we can be in more of a facilitator or an observer role, just making sure that things are going okay. Honestly, the goal is such that by the last 1 to 2 months, there's a lot of independence where the fellows have come to a point where they know how to take care of a vast majority of the trauma problems that come in. They're familiar with our overall philosophy and techniques for doing the surgeries, and then we can kind of sit back and just kind of fine tune the last month or two as they get ready to graduate for independent practice.